What have you signed up for today? What are you getting done?
My lip pop.
A lip pop. And what does a lip pop mean, Jess?
It's making my lips a little bigger.
A little bigger.
Just the top.
And why would you want a lip pop, Jack? Is it, Jess, is it a sexier look? Is it, what
kind
of look is it?
Little pouty look.
Little pouty look. And every girl wants a little pouty look, huh?
Yep.
Right on. Right. So you're excited.
Yeah.
Are you scared? Are you nervous?
It's a little nervous.
We've got some real needles going here, right?
All right.
Dr. Trine, if you could tell everybody what a lip pop is, and then kind of a 4-in-1 on the wonderful world of Botox and how Botox works, and you know, and who does it, and what does it cost, and what areas in the face people are doing, and then we'll get into lip pop here.
Sure. So what Botox is, it's a neurotoxin. It's the most popular one on the market, and what we use it for is just to put the muscle in its relaxed state temporarily. It lasts about 3 months, and the reason you would do that is because when the body creates those little movements, you actually make microtraumas and wrinkles or lines in the face. And when those lines happen, the body wants to heal it. We just really make too many faces too often to be able to heal those lines. So when you relax the muscles, then we can prevent new damage from forming. The thing that it does around the lip area, though, is when we relax this muscle here, it's actually going to make the lip give the illusion of just kind of turning out slightly. So that is for someone who wants a little more volume but doesn't want to commit to filler.
Are you ready, Jess?
Yeah.
Let's do it, Dr. Trine. Let's do it. I'm excited. Everybody, Dr. Trine is one of our instructors. She teaches physicians and nurses from across the world. People flying from Dubai, Canada, Mexico, Chicago, Boston, New York, to our various locations to learn how to safely and effectively do Botox and dermal fillers. And how many little injections do we do in this lip pop area, Dr. Trine?
What we're doing is one unit per side. I'm going to have her turn just a little bit here. This is our second one.
Okay.
One, two, three. And this is what's gonna give that lip a little tiny turnout. Now, Jess also wanted a little bit of a kind of gummy smile correction. And what that means is
what does that mean, a gummy smile correction?
A little gummy smile.
What do you have, my dear? What's the problem here?
Yes.
My gums show.
We can see your gums when you smile and you wanna make that go away?
Yeah.
I didn't know we can make that go away, Dr. Trine.
Well, we can. And so what we do is basically what I just did around the mouth here was for the lip pop. But then what I do is I go a little higher here so I can show you how I do that. It's gonna be very similar. One, two, three. And what this is gonna do is just kind of drop, one, two, three, drop that lip down, and that was it, so that when she smiles, you won't see as much of her gum line there. And that can just be a little bit nicer for people who are self-conscious.
She's excited, look at her, she's smiling already. It hasn't started kicking in yet. Dr. Trine, how does it take before that starts kicking in here?
Usually it takes anywhere from 1 to 14 days, but I do have patients report that around the mouth, they feel it very quickly.
Amazing. So, how did that feel, Jess?
Just a little sting.
Is it better now? Is it fine now?
Yeah.
So not a big deal?
Yeah, I'm ready to go out.
What are the most common areas that people come and asking for you to, you know, for you to treat? And how long does it take you to do this area? I know that was a quick one, but what's the norm for all these areas?
Basically, the most common areas are going to be the little 11s right here. The forehead.
The angry lines.
Yeah,
the
little angry lines.
Do you have an angry face? Oh, right there.
Exactly.
Right there? Okay,
okay. Yep, and around the crow's feet. Those are the most popular areas, but we can also do other things like a little nose area here for bunny lines is what we call it. We can do a TMJ muscle. We can even do maybe down at the corners of the mouth to lift those. A little bit. Right. So we really have a lot of options with Botox.
Now I know Allergan and all the drug companies, they talk about on-label treatments and off-label treatments. I know Allergan on TV, when they advertise, they can only talk about certain areas in the face on-label, but all the doctors and nurses can also inject the off-label. So what's the difference between on-label and off-label? Is it just a legal thing or?
It basically what it means is that FDA approves on-label areas, and that's what that means. So the off-label means that FDA hasn't approved that, but the reason is because it's really hard to push certain drugs through every single process with the FDA. So a lot of people are doing it because it has the same exact, you know, function and mechanism of action. So we know that it's safe, but we always want to get consent from the patient.